Russell Westbrook is the best player on the Rockets. Or is he? Is Lonzo Ball the best player on the Pelicans? Or is it Zion? I'm ranking the best player from every NBA team. Number 30, Charlotte Hornets. Terry Rozier. But that's not saying much because their team is terrible. Get that off my screen. That team is awful. Number 29, Chicago Bulls. Zach LaVine or Lauri Markkanen? LaVine is averaging 24 points per game, has a better 3-point percentage than Lauri, is way more athletic. I'm going with Zach LaVine. Number 28, Memphis Grizzlies. It's the same answer every season, Mike Conley. Oh wait, he got traded! Finally, we have a new superstar in Memphis, and his name is Jaren Jackson Jr. He scored 14 points per game in his rookie season in Memphis. Oh, what about Ja Morant? No, Jaren Jackson Jr. is their best player. Number 27, Cleveland Cavaliers. I was so close to picking Colin because he had a great rookie year, but not today. I'm going with Kevin Love. He still puts up all-star numbers. He just gets hurt a lot. But when he's healthy, Kevin Love is the best player on the Cavaliers. Number 26, Atlanta Hawks. Trae Young just had an amazing season. He almost beat Luka Doncic for Rookie of the Year. But you know what's even crazier? He's not the best player on the Hawks. It's John Collins. Let's compare them. John Collins scored more points, more rebounds, and had a way better field goal percentage. He's also a better defender. Just because Trae Young has a bigger name and everyone talks about him does not mean he's better than John Collins. Number 25, New Orleans Pelicans. Warning, I'm about to get a lot of you mad. Zion Williamson, the number one overall pick, or Brandon Ingram? Is Zion their best player without even playing in the NBA? What if I told you it's not Zion and it's not Brandon Ingram? The best player on the Pelicans is Lonzo Ball. But his stats aren't even close. It's not all about the stats. Lonzo is the best passing point guard, the best defensive point guard. Lonzo was already great, but now he has a jump shot? Case closed. Number 24, Sacramento Kings. Fun fact, Buddy Hield is faster than De'Aaron Fox. Buddy Hield's stats are also better than De'Aaron Fox. But I'm still going with De'Aaron Fox. Why? Because he makes a bigger impact on the game. He took this team from last place to almost making the playoffs. Sometimes it's about who makes a bigger impact on their team. Number 23, New York Knicks. Wow, so many options. Is RJ Barrett already their best player? Mitchell Robinson, he just had an amazing rookie year. No and no. It's their new star, Julius Randle. What do you mean star? He's not a star. Yes, he is. If he played on the Lakers or the Warriors, people would act like he's the next Michael Jordan. But because he was on the Pelicans last year, no one really talked about him. Number 22, Oklahoma City Thunder. CP3 is not our best player. I'm sorry, but he's not. He had a down season, his defense isn't the same as it used to be, and he hasn't even played for the Thunder yet. The OKC Thunder's best player is Aquaman. He literally boxed out for Russell Westbrook, let Westbrook get all the rebounds, and he still got 10 rebounds a game for himself. Imagine how many he's gonna get this season. He's also one of the best defenders in the NBA. Oh yeah, and no big deal, he can also make three-pointers now. Steven Adams is the best. Number 21, Toronto Raptors. Kyle Lowry just signed a one-year, $33 million contract. That's crazy. You know what's even crazier? He's not their best player. The best player on the Toronto Raptors is Pascal Siakam. 17 points. 7 rebounds, he carried them to a title. I'm telling you, if it wasn't for Pascal, The Warriors would have won the title last season. He's one of the most underrated players in the entire NBA. And without Kawhi on the team, he's easily the best on the Raptors. Number 20, Boston Celtics. In 5 years, it will be Jason Tatum. But right now, it's obviously Kemba Walker. Last season, he had 26 points per game. So how is someone scoring 26 a game only number 20 on the list? Well, he did that on the Charlotte Hornets, and they had nobody else to score. So it's impressive, but not that impressive. Number 19, Detroit Pistons. It's between Blake Griffin and Andre Drummond. Blake scores way more points, but only 7 rebounds? Ew! Andre Drummond scores 17 points, 15 rebounds, 2 blocks, and now he can make 3-pointers? Ooh, never mind. But he's still the best player on the Pistons. Number 18, Phoenix Suns. Devin Booker. Nobody on that team is even close. Is DeAndre Ayton scoring 27 points a game? I didn't think so. Number 17, Dallas Mavericks. This is easily the toughest decision of the video. Kristaps Porzingis and Luka Doncic, the best young duo in the entire NBA. So Luka just won Rookie of the Year. Kristaps didn't play last year, he was hurt. But we all know he has superstar talent. It's not even a question. Offensively, it's a tie. So the tiebreaker is defense. And with 2.5 blocks, 1 steal per game, the tiebreaker goes to Kristaps Porzingis. Number 16, San Antonio Spurs. Who do you think scores more points? DeMar DeRozan or LaMarcus Aldridge? LaMarcus, who has a higher field goal percentage? LaMarcus, who is more efficient? LaMarcus, who lost to me in a one-on-one? DeMar DeRozan. But all jokes aside, LaMarcus Aldridge just had the best season of his career and is the best player on the Spurs. Number 15, Miami Heat. It's Jimmy Butler. I was gonna put LaMarcus Aldridge ahead of Jimmy on the list because offensively, LaMarcus is absolutely better. But when he tries, Jimmy Butler is a top 5 defender. Number 14, Indiana Pacers. It's between Victor Oladipo and Malcolm Brogdon, their new signing. Brogdon is a slightly better 3-point scorer, but Oladipo is way more athletic. But Vic is one of the best defensive guards in the entire league. He's been an all-star 2 years in a row, and now he is healthy. So Oladipo is the best player on the Pacers. Number 13, Minnesota Timberwolves. 5 years ago, Andrew Wiggins was predicted to be the number 2 best player in the entire NBA. But they were wrong. The best player on the Timberwolves is obviously Karl Anthony Towns. If you only look at his stats, he looks like an MVP candidate. And 1 year, he might be. But his impact just isn't there. Because the Timberwolves, even though they have all this talent, they keep missing the playoffs. If he carries them to the playoffs this season, he'll be higher on the list in 2020. Number 12, Washington Wizards. Wait a minute, the Wizards are one of the worst teams in the league. How are they number 12? Because they have one good player, and his name is Bradley Beal. If I have to explain why he's the best player on the team, I'm gonna end up roasting the entire Wizards roster. So let's just move on. Number 11, Orlando Magic. Nikola Vucevic. He's not exciting, but he's pretty incredible. Vucevic has a higher player efficiency than Stephen Curry, Kevin Durant, and many other superstars. He's one of the best players and most underrated players in the NBA. Number 10, Portland Trailblazers. It's between CJ McCollum and Damian Lillard. It's a tough decision. Psych! It's obviously Damian Lillard. He ended the OKC Thunder franchise with one bucket. How's that for impact? Number 9, Denver Nuggets. The Nuggets are the deepest team in the league, so you would think it's a tough choice. But it's not. Their best player is Nikola Jokic, the Joker. And last season, he was an MVP candidate. Hopefully he gets back in shape though, because in the preseason, he's looking a little bit chubby. Number 8, Utah Jazz. The easy answer is Donovan Mitchell. He's the big name, 25 points per game. It has to be him. Well, it's not. Don't get me wrong, I love D. Mitch, but Rudy Gobert is a top 10 player in this league. 2 years in a row, he's won Defensive Player of the Year. Usually, really good defenders are just terrible at offense. Well, Rudy Gobert is an exception, because on offense, he was amazing too. If Gobert was on the Lakers, people would talk about him like he's the next Shaq. But he's in Utah, and no one really talks about Utah. Number 7, Philadelphia 76ers. Ben Simmons almost averaged a triple-double in 2019. He made a three-pointer in the preseason. But the 76ers happen to have the best center in the NBA, Joel Embiid. He's pretty much Rudy Gobert, except even better on offense. If Ben Simmons starts hitting three-pointers consistently, my answer is gonna change. But for right now, the best player is Joel Embiid. Number 6, Los Angeles Clippers. Oh boy. Kawhi Leonard or Paul George? Bro, this is the definition of a tie. And my tiebreaker is defense, and they're tied on defense. What's the double tiebreaker? Impact. Kawhi Leonard somehow took the Toronto Raptors to the NBA championship and beat the Golden State Warriors. Kawhi Leonard is the best player on the LA Clippers. Number 5, Los Angeles Lakers. Oh my goodness. Can a team with LeBron James have a better player than LeBron? I mean, LeBron has always been impressive, but they just got Anthony Davis. I know half of you probably think it's LeBron and the other half think it's Anthony Davis, but to be honest, everyone should know Anthony Davis is the best player on the Lakers. He's another one of those players that was on a team nobody really talked about, the Pelicans, and now, when he scores 30 points a game, gets 15 rebounds, 7 blocks a game in Los Angeles, everyone's gonna talk about him a lot more. He's the best player on the Lakers. Number 4, Brooklyn Nets. Kevin Durant or Kyrie Irving? Kyrie is so confusing. He puts up so many points, but sometimes the points don't really matter. I mean, look at the Celtics last year. He had the numbers, but they didn't really do that good. But Kevin Durant had Steph, Klay Thompson, which means he had a lot more space to get open shots. I mean, it's super close, but I'm gonna go with Kevin Durant. KD is the best player on the Nets. And some of you might be surprised that Anthony Davis and KD and even Kawhi are not in the top 3. I'm sorry, they're all great, but they're not the top 3. Number 3, Golden State Warriors. Steph Curry is the best 3-point scorer of this generation. He's a 2-time MVP. And now that Kevin Durant went to Brooklyn, I think he's about to score 30 points a game again. Number 2, Milwaukee Bucks. Giannis Antetokounmpo. This dude is built like Shaquille O'Neal. Everyone knows he's going to the basket and it doesn't matter. He runs at the basket, pulls a Euro step, and dunks in your face. Oh, you're in the way? Okay, he'll jump over you and then dunk on somebody else's face. It's not a surprise that he's the best player on the Bucks, but it might be a surprise that I only put him at number 2. Number 1, Houston Rockets. Obviously, the best player in the NBA, no doubt about it, is James Harden, the best offensive player in the history of the NBA. Last video, I did the 7 greatest freaks of nature in the NBA. Go watch that right now. I'll put it somewhere on the screen for you to click. It's one of my favorite videos I've done recently. And subscribe!